Atomic Fiction is a visual effects and animation company here in the San Francisco Bay Area. We really kind of deal with the entire range of visual effects, everything from very transparent effects, digital environments that we did for Looper, sort of explosions that you might see in a movie like Flight, and then we have actually a really, really amazing digital human pipeline.
Well, the philosophy behind Atomic Fiction is talent first. We have absolutely A-list talent working here, and we've tried to pair that A-list talent with really smart technology and a generalist approach in using tools that are off the shelf and things like rendering in the cloud. We really didn't want to develop our own software. We wanted to leave that to the professionals, such as the folks at Autodesk.
So that's where the Entertainment Creation Suite comes in really, really handy. An artist is going to have access to Mudbox for, you know, that detail sculpting and texturing. They're going to be able to, you know, throw it into Maya and update it quickly to see if it works on the rig. The matte painters are going to be able to model in Maya because that's where they're comfortable with, but then do their reprojections in 3ds Max.
At a bigger studio, I might be relegated to one department. At Atomic Fiction, I can, you know, work in lighting, compositing, rigging, animation. I've done editorial stuff. You know, there's just a million different roles that I can fill.
Flight is Robert Zemeckis' return to live action after several years doing some motion capture films. We were the sole visual effects vendor on the project that consisted of digital environments, CG airplanes, effects work, and really just quite a few hidden effects.
We used almost every tool in the Autodesk Entertainment Creation Suite. We not only had to do the computer-generated plane, which was animated and rendered in Maya using V-Ray, but we had to do, you know, fuel dump spray coming off the back of the wings, which was done in 3ds Max. We had to go in, re-engineer the camera move. Bob wanted a different sky on it, so we ended up tweaking a lot of that shot. The camera move was designed in Maya by the animator, and then the matte painter picked that up in 3ds Max. Flight is an honest-to-God, totally cloud-rendered film. We're really proud of that and the fact that we were able to push through 400 shots entirely in the cloud. It's sort of proof in the pudding that the concept really works.
It's pretty much a game changer. It's basically allowing us to take on much larger amounts of work than we would typically have been able to do and get the company off the ground in a way that wouldn't have been possible 5 or 6 years ago.
One of the other really key components, in addition to processing data in the cloud, is making sure that information is available to people across the company at any time. So production management tools like Shotgun ties in with Maya and Max and helps you task artists, helps you track statuses of shots, what's been delivered, what still has to go. That level of flexibility is what makes it absolutely magical and super cost effective and better for the artists at the end of the day. Over the summer, we had a few spare cycles to show off our digital humans capabilities. We went and found a location, got a DP who came in, and we did the whole thing like it was a real shoot.
Once the HDR for the project was all stitched together from the bracketed photos that we had created, I took that into Maya and used a spherical projection to project that onto this 3D geometry that we had created through the match move.
So as a character moves past the door, it walks into and out of the light. So making this sort of spatial HDR, the scene almost lit itself.
Part of the reason that we've been competitive is because of off-the-shelf software, like Maya, 3ds Max, Mudbox. They've allowed us to keep up with bigger companies that are using all proprietary software and do same quality of work.
So for us, it is really amazing to be able to leverage tools like the Autodesk products. It allows us to have what we kind of call, it's a big shop infrastructure, but a small shop attitude.